My name is Michelle Carre. I'm the host of Challenge Accepted, and today we're going to show you a little behind the scenes of what it takes to make the biggest episode we've ever made.
We're watching the finale of this episode that Ryan has edited and Max has assisted edited. I'm so excited. I'm always excited to see Ryan's edits, and I often scream when I get to see them. Or cry. One of the two. Two emotions.
If you get either, it's a really good thing.
This is the difference between the original source material that we are homaging. Our story is the creation of this moment versus the Mission Impossible story is Ethan Hunt looking badass as he's doing it.
Correct.
The beauty of YouTube is such a ragtag team of people coming together to make something this crazy happen. And I think that is our story. Like, that is our heart of the piece.
This is the same problem we had in our Houdini episode. We have a third act in which our protagonist has no dialogue. And so we have the challenge right now of attempting to tell that tension, the fear, the drama, the conflict, all visually.
The transition is the moment. It's the moment you lose complete control, and the only thing left to do is to hold on.
We showed this to like 10 people, and like halfway through the shot, they actually stopped to like ask us questions. And I realized, oh my God, we weren't keeping them engaged in the hero shot. The issue we ran into is, how do you visually tell that the plane's going faster? That plane is like quadrupling in speed, but you can't tell.
So what we were able to do is actually add camera shake and post to help understand the intensity that Michelle is currently feeling from the wind. So what we did to do that is I brought the shot into After Effects. I actually used an effect called the wiggle tool, which just wiggles the footage around. But what's really cool about it is you can control and keyframe how much you want over time, which just simply allowed me just to put two keyframes, one in the beginning, one at the end, and it will naturally start building the shake over time to sell that sense of velocity increasing, speed increasing, the intensity increasing. And what we got in the end, it tells the story, like it shuts me up. I don't think I'm talking. Yeah, I'm not talking over it.
A lot of what Michelle and Ryan have been saying is like the heart of the piece is like the crew in the episode. But that also means, because there's no dialogue for Michelle, the crew's reactions to what's happening is sort of how we tell the emotional journey of Michelle. And so we've been mining our footage for micro expressions that could help tell that visual story.
Yeah. Can you open up all the cameras for me real quick? I want to see what Video Village is doing the moment the transition happens.
That's the reaction you already have in the cut.
Correct.
Yeah, he cheats it later. Garrett's reaction here, where he blinks like this. That's amazing.
That's a very real reaction.
That's gotta be used somewhere. It's so nice to be able to see exactly what each person was experiencing at the same time.
I'd say the biggest hurdle to tackle with this project is how many cameras we're using for one multicam sequence. That has definitely been kind of a struggle in terms of like knowing what selects and how I should pull them exactly to help you the most.
So one of the big story points that we need to tell in this video is the danger of having birds in the air.
The things that are not in our control, bird strike, that would be a bad roll of the dice.
Anybody who's close to me knows I don't like birds.
Nice.
I don't like birds.
When Michelle was flying, holding onto the side of a plane, a bird can be the difference between life or death. This is a very real danger. We're gonna need more shots of birds. So if you go up here on the top right and you click on this little magnifying glass, that is media intelligence, which allows you just to search anything you want, no matter how specific it is. I can use media intelligence to actually just search for birds, and it'll give me a bunch of different results that I can just drag and drop in the timeline. And there's a section here I'm dragging it into where our director is talking about the things that he fears and the things that make him anxious. And so if I play this clip.
Garrett, how are you feeling?
I am feeling unusually anxious, but.
Whoa.
So he's saying, I feel unusually anxious, and throughout this video we set up the dangers of these birds. Being able to find it so quickly in media intelligence and dragging in adds so much to the story.
Did you have a moment on the plane, Michelle, when you genuinely started having fun?
Yeah.
Do we want to have a beat in the stunt in which you actually start having fun?
I think it would be nice, and then we bring it back with the landing.
I like the words you used earlier before Michelle got here, Ryan, which was the C-130 is a monster. And that evoked this imagery of like, Michelle is taming this massive mythical beast that is the plane. And as she is like very afraid of it, I think it would feel really cool to have a moment of like How to Train Your Dragon style, like, I've got the dragon tamed.
That is such a great metaphor.
Like, we got the thing and I'm having fun.
So originally, most of the final challenge was just fear. So Michelle had the note, she's like, honestly, I got to a point where I enjoyed it. Why don't we tell that story? We added a little section here where Michelle is having fun. But before that, we also added a section where it's almost kind of like the lowest point of the challenge. If you really want to have a really high point, having a contrasting valley, a low point right beforehand, really accents the highs.
Yeah, I really like this beat that you added, Ryan.
Thank you.
To achieve the heroicism that you were just talking about, mm-hmm. you actually just made the section right before it even darker. Mm-hmm. Like, that lower low made the higher even higher. She's loving it. Of course she is.
There are multiple beats once the plane's in the air. Mm-hmm. The plane's taking off, oh my god, this is terrifying, then it's, oh my god, this is so much fun, and then it goes to, oh wait, wait, we still have to land this thing. So there's all these little mini scenes within that.
The C-130 is turning onto final. Hopefully we'll be able to get her back onto the platform for the landing. All right, come on, Michelle.
And I'm wondering if that fluctuation in mood would help, being like, holy shit, I tamed the beast, but now we gotta land the thing.
Yeah.
But there is power in a new conflict that we hadn't even discussed before.
So the fun pod is a high, but then as Garrett said, we're not out of the woods yet. Now we have to land this thing.
Conflict does two things. It develops character and it progresses the plot. And so in this situation, we need to keep re-engaging different conflicts in order to do those two things. A lot of it for me is that the parallax of the background whizzing behind Michelle actually sells the speed a lot faster than the red shot frontal of her. And the framing is always that the lead room is below her, showing like the distance she has to fall. Mm-hmm.
That is our master shot for the sequence, right? But talk about contrast again, it gets really loud, right? We have the drums playing. Into silence. Almost like a heartbeat, right? It's reacting to everyone else's emotion, what they were probably feeling on set, because if you've ever been in a tense moment like that, your hearing becomes tunneled. I always say like editing is life experience just told on the screen. I'm just kind of replicating this feeling I have whenever I have these tense moments. It's authentic, it's their authentic reaction to it.
I think the only way that I didn't have a full-blown panic attack was because of our team. There's no one I trust more to strap me into a rocket than Steve Brown and his team. And so it was very important to me to have Steve and Sean and Team Red Bull behind all of this so that we could do it in the most thrilling way possible and also as safely as possible. Thank you so much, Adobe, for this incredible opportunity to tell our story. And thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, be sure to let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll hopefully see you for another BTS episode.